What's up, fellas? Feast your eyes here. Another absolute dime piece out of the time machine here. Another time capsule from 1990. Probably the nicest original paint low mile FXR on the market for sale today. This baby's got 6,774 miles on it. This is a 1990 model, which one of the most desirable years of the FXRs. For the later models, they had a lot of improvements over the earlier ones, and this one is absolute perfection. It's been polished to perfection and has some real high-end upgrades on it. I guess I'll start at the front end. That's the original factory Harley-Davidson mag that was sent out and chromed, along with the fork lowers, which are from the Harley catalog chrome. This got the chrome Harley-Davidson fork brace. It's got the upgraded rotor. The caliper is in brand new condition and also has a braided stainless brake line on it. So heading up to the handlebars, it's got a set of 10-inch T-bars, risers, which are awesome. That's what everybody wants today. It's got one of the Corbin Gunfighter leather saddles on it with the embossed flames on it. The paint job off the hook. We have four FXRs in stock. All the guys in the shop, unanimously, this is the paint job a lot of them like the most. Myself, I like the black one, but I bought in 1983 a brand new 1983 FXR lowrider with this paint job on it, the same exact paint job, and it's just beautiful. It's a candy apple red with the orange pinstripes on it, the Harley-Davidson logo. The paint job's absolutely beautiful on this thing. 6,700 miles. It was owned by George Audi. The only reason he sold his Harleys was he wanted room in his garage for a street rod, and him and his wife, Christina, agreed that the bike had to go. So he called me up, and we bought all three of them. This one is absolutely stunning. The rear wheel, same thing. Do a close-up on the rear wheel. It's a professionally chromed factory mag, Harley-Davidson mag wheel with the brand-new matching to the front rotor. The brakes are phenomenal on this thing. The paint job's awesome. Has a nice custom license plate holder on there. Has the original factory suspension on the front and the rear. The motor is the 80 cubic inch, 1340 cc 80 cubic inch low rider evolution motor. Has the original factory air cleaner on this side with the low rider logo on it. My favorite exhaust, it's got a thunder header exhaust. Of course, mid controls. A lot of people made the mistake of putting forwards on these. Don't recommend it. These are highly sought after in this configuration with the mid controls. Just a beautiful piece. The chrome primary cover on this side. The black wrinkle finish on the motor is beautiful. It has a lot of parts right out of the Harley catalog. Like, these are Harley-Davidson chrome side covers. It has the chrome triangle cover. It's got the chrome upper belt guard, chrome lower belt guard, and a chrome pulley cover. So basically, everything but the swing arm down here has been chromed, and it's absolutely spotless. It's just been massaged to perfection here at the museum. Doc spent a full 8-hour day. Gave what we call a rotisserie detail. It was steam cleaned, hand washed. All the painted surfaces were buffed and waxed. All the chrome was polished. From the bottom of the frame to the top of the handlebars, it is absolutely spotless. The tires were also replaced. It's got a new set of tires on it when they did the chroming on it. They're Metzler, a set of matched Metzlers on the back here. It's an ME880 Marathon on the rear. You got a matching one on the front. Still has the hairy nubs on the tires. Just a beautiful piece. Once it got through the detail shop, went to Mario. Mario changed the engine oil and filter, changed the primary chain case fluid, changed the transmission fluid, transmission gear oil, actually rinsed out the gas tank and put VP non-ethanol fuel in there, which is the best thing for a carbureted engine. It won't clog it up. So it's got a brand new complete CV carb rebuild kit on it, along with the intake seal. So he took the whole intake off. Replaced the intake seals and rebuilt the carburetor and cleaned out the air filter. The exhaust, again, is my favorite exhaust. All of my Harleys, all three of my Harleys have thunder headers on them. My CVO Dyna and my FXR have thunder headers. In my opinion, the best exhaust, because when you're riding it, the exhaust tips all the way here past the back axle. I don't like the short pipes that are right here because it's right in your ear, so you get a really good sound, but it's not right in your ear.
And the two-in-one has better exhaust scavenging, which means more horsepower on the dyno. So
amen. Yeah, more power, better performance, it's lighter, and also the front of the pipe has been wrapped in the black heat tape. Mario just did that too, so he had the whole exhaust off, wrapped that, so it needs nothing, it's ready to go. If you have any questions about it, give us a call, 860-454-7024. Bike Week starts a week from this Friday. That means the start of a new bike season. There aren't FXRs for sale out there like this. You just don't find 6,000-mile original paint beauties like this that haven't been bastardized. This motor is 100% bone stock. No one's even ever taken the valve covers off of it. It's basically a brand new Evolution motor, one of the best engines Harley ever made. So even has the initial, the original cam cover with the V2 on here. Nobody's been in there messing with the cams. No one's messed with the heads of the cylinders. It's 100% original stock, all fresh fluids in it, brand new battery. We just put a battery in there. And of course, the only performance upgrade to the engine has been the exhaust, and you have to do that. The stock Harley exhaust systems are ridiculously restrictive. So just a beautiful piece. Definitely Kaplan America approved. If you're looking for a pristine original FXR that's got some tasteful upgrades, buy this bike because they're becoming a super rare commodity in today's market. Thanks for watching, and God bless America.